Hello everybody, thanks for tuning in. Today I went to my garden, you know, just thinking I was gonna harvest like a little bit of salad, just a few cucumbers, because I thought it would only be like two cucumbers and maybe like a Ziploc freezer bag of green beans. And I realized, you know, all this time I've been only picking enough, you know, I would pick only as many green beans as I would cook. So today I was like, let me try to harvest all the beans from every single plant on my allotment plot. Good news and bad news. I didn't get to harvest all the beans from every single plant because the mosquitoes after a while just started coming out as it got later, as the sun went down. It was horrible. But I got, I want to say about two quarters, maybe three quarters. No, yeah, like two quarters of the green beans picked. And I'm gonna show y'all the rest, but it's crazy. I never really put myself on the camera, so I figured why not. Only thing is, since I'm recording from my iPhone, I'm not gonna be able to flip the camera now since I already started recording like this. So I'm gonna just do this. Excuse me. Matter of fact, I'm gonna put on a shirt. Y'all, sorry for my nakedness. One sec. I just threw on the first random shirt I seen. So, harvested another thing of lettuce. I'm gonna eat this within the next 2 days or it'll go bad. That's normally what happens. A lot of green onions or shallots, as some people call them. I think I might use these in some egg fried rice. A lot of green onions. And I always try to take my phone with me so I can do, you know, a live harvest, or you know, like record the whole process. But like I said, the mosquitoes sometimes are just too pesky. So when I went out, I was just expecting to get this much, right? Just one bag, maybe not even this full. But then I did another bag. I busted open. It was so many. My patio tomato plant, which didn't do so well when it was on my porch or my patio, it just wouldn't produce any tomatoes, really. And I figured, you know, maybe this pot isn't big enough for it and needs more room to grow its roots out. Since I've did that, it has taken off very well. Now, a lot of people may be looking at this and saying, oh, those tomatoes aren't even ready. They're still green. Some are still small. But the reason for me doing that was because a lot of bugs was like eating holes into them, or you know, since I don't get to go out to the garden as often as I would like, see something like this, a lot of them would end up like that, or like a deeper hole completely into it because of the slugs and just things like that. So I picked a bunch of these, you know, at the ideal size that I would like them to be, and I'll just leave them in the windowsill and let them ripen. That way they won't grow anymore, but they will be protected from any further damage. See, some bug or something even like dug deep into that one. So there's about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Way more tomatoes than I remember. So about 25 tomatoes. I was shocked by that. My cucumber plant still doing very well. I got 1, 2, 3, 4. Ah, that one still has its spikes on there. 4, 5, 6, 7 cucumbers. Oh, another tomato. See, that's about almost 30 tomatoes. Like I said, I only got to harvest about two-fourths of my green bean plants. This is the third bag. So I would like to imagine there is at least the other two-quarters. Maybe like 3 to 4 more bags of green beans left. And then also, since I didn't bring enough bags or whatever, I had to throw these other beans in there. What I'm going to do with that is bag those, actually. Talked to my friend who also has a plot in the garden, and he said that I should blanch them, you know, put them in boiling hot water, dry them off, and then freeze them to preserve the ones I won't eat right away. And that's about maybe 3 of these 4 bags I won't eat right away. I eat them a lot, so I figure like one bag I'll go through maybe like a few days, if not a week at the most. And I'm also glad I started to pick these because I've seen a lot of these beans were also being damaged by bugs or whatever the case may be. I'll see if I can find an example. There were a bunch that looked like that, if you can see that. Like something had started to eat into it or they were starting to rot. I found one plant that was just completely molded out. You know, like there wasn't enough airflow in that area because I planted them so tight. And I hadn't been harvesting them, so yeah, that plant I just completely pulled up. I was sad to do so, but it didn't look like there would be any hope for it, so I just pulled it out. Plus, they're super jam-packed together, so I figured that would help all the other plants. So that was my harvest for the day. It's a nice one there. I'm gonna let this video only go for a little bit longer, but. As you can see, this is the Select Salad Blend lettuce that I had planted earlier. And here you can see I forget the names of these, if I'm not mistaken. Correct me if you guys know and I say it wrong. This here looks like let me bring it in light a little bit. The red romaine lettuce here, the burgundy looking ones. Butter Crunch, I think it's called. I think Butter Crunch here. A lot of the other bushels of Select Salad Blend have more varieties. This one looks like it's just 2 varieties. And then I also have a butternut squash. 1 second. Now this one I did not grow. My buddy in the garden, he gave me this as a gift because I gave him a bunch of my lettuce. He really enjoyed that. And these are the other 3 cucumbers I harvested the other day. It was just these and a few beans I got to put in the dish, so I didn't really record it. But yeah, I've been harvesting a lot of green onions, a lot of cucumbers, tomatoes, green beans, salad. Next video, I will record live in the garden, no matter how many mosquitoes or whatever. My watermelon is doing super well. Like, there's one watermelon that's like this big up on my trellis, and there's a other bunch of little ones that's starting to grow. My peas I planted, just because the watermelon was right next to it, it kind of choked it out. But there's literally one single pea plant that's flowering and it's producing some peas. So I'll show you guys that as well. Just trying to think of what else I start in the garden. That's about it. And as the fall or spring, I always get it confused. Don't judge me. I don't keep up with the seasons. I just go by whatever the weather is. But as the next season approaches, I will be planting more spinach because that didn't take off this year when I planted it originally. More salad. And that'll be all. But this is my harvest, you guys. Oh, salad, the cucumbers, all the tomatoes. Oh, cucumbers. Tomatoes. Green beans. And the green onions there. This is my first time doing this format of video, so please bear with me. Let me know if you guys like this versus the reverse camera. I do want to show you one last thing. 1 second. So with all the cucumbers I showed you guys in my other video, I was putting a lot of them in salads. I was just eating a lot of them by herself, or just cucumbers and ranch. But after so many, I was like, running out of ideas. I don't want to eat them all at this. What should I do? So my buddy that gave me the butternut squash, he helped me pickle these cucumbers. August 30th, we pickled these. I'm not sure if you can see that. That's the date. H&S is hot and spicy. And classic is just the, I think it was, you know, just the original classic pickle flavor. I had about 6 jars of these. I have like 3 left now, maybe 4. So yeah, that's the idea for you guys if you ever want to consider something. Pickle all those extra cucumbers you don't know what to do with. The small amount I harvested today, that'll just be salads and just eating on their own. And that is all I have for today. Hope you guys enjoyed that. And I'm just super happy on how well it did. Comment, subscribe, like, all that crazy stuff. Let me know what you guys think. Comment. Let me know if you uploaded videos, because a lot of people I subscribe to, for some reason I don't get the notifications anymore. But let me know. I definitely still support, you know, check it out, comment, all those good things. Till next time, Milwaukee Backyard Gardener tuning out.